Hi, this is Carly Opson, your instructor for SERP 590, Single Case Research Design. Excuse the GW cap, George Washington. My son goes to school there. My head was cold. It was handy. And, I don't know if you have kids in college, but I can tell you, once you sign the check for them to go someplace, you kind of automatically become a fan. So I am a fan of my alma mater, University of Kentucky, College of Charleston, Arizona, and George Washington University at this point. This week is week 10. Week 10, guys, we're so close. Looking ahead, we'll have one more design of the week next week for week 11. And then week 12... it will be really immersive, focusing on graphing. And then the next 3 weeks of the class, pretty much I'm gonna just do nothing but help you focus on completing your final project. I'll just present you piece by piece, have you send me pieces, have you send each other pieces. We'll get this thing done in a really constructive way, all right? But this week, week 10, comparison designs, pretty cool, really. We're moving out of the realm of demonstration designs, A-B, withdrawal, multiple probe, multiple baseline. Those are all about demonstrating the effectiveness of a single intervention. Comparison designs are about comparing interventions. It's an ugly business. I'll tell you that much. It can be difficult to do properly, and I'm going to walk you through in some of the information this week why that's the case. The book does so also. Right. So this week, the three activities are just kind of like the design of the week activities for last week. In the first activity, you'll learn about comparison design. So I've created a video for you. It's a little longer than usual. It's about a 15-minute video, but it goes all the way through the elements of comparison designs and the differences. It's a bit of a complex topic. It's a really nerdy topic, but it's something that if you've taken a research course in single case design, you need to know the difference. Right. Then I'm gonna ask you to read, skim, to whatever degree you choose, some articles that are comparison design articles. Some of them are really funky and interesting. And then I'm going to ask you to create a discussion post with a little twist to it this week, because I think we need to do that based on what most of your research questions are. Let's take an in-depth look at what's going on this week for just a moment. First of all, I gave you a link to the Ledford and Gast. As I've said before, it's probably better for you to watch the video first to get a basic introduction to these designs and then go back and do the reading, and then you can pick and choose places where you really want to focus in the reading and places where you want to let up because you already understand it based on what you've seen in the video. Okay. So there's the video, there is the link to the text. Then there are these comparison designs. And these says alternating treatments. We'll talk about that. But just understand that these are comparison designs, okay? So this first one is on the effects of exergaming. So they compare regular PE to no PE to exergaming and the physical activity for individuals. Then the next study is about decreasing vocal stereotypy in a student with autism. Using an antecedent intervention and I can't remember exactly how it was that they switch it up and have multiple interventions in there, multiple antecedent interventions. I'd have to go back and look at that one. The next one is a comparison of function-based differential reinforcement interventions. I know that at least one or two of your research questions have to do with differential reinforcement, so I'm sure some of you will find that particularly interesting. The next is the effects of choice making. Okay, so on toy engagement. The last two are pretty funky. The next one is another sports piece, and it's improved curveball hitting through enhancement of visual cues. Basically, they wanted to see that whether or not they could improve the ability of an individual batter to learn to follow the flight of a ball and hit it with a bat, and if they could do it better by painting markers on the balls. Okay, so they've got balls with no markers, markers, balls with markers. And then, oh, and different size markers too. So they have like three different comparison pieces they do. And the final one, kind of controversial stuff. In the field of applied behavior analysis, there is some skepticism about sensory interventions. This is one of those articles. It's about the effect of weighted vests. And so they've got no vest, weighted vest, and then they do something really interesting. They include a vest with no weight in it, just to see if it's the vest itself or is it actually the weight. I'm sure a number of you would be interested in taking a look at that piece, because I bet you guys are involved with sensory interventions all the time. So after you read, then I'd ask you to go to the discussion post. So here's how this one's a little bit different. I know that most of you don't have research questions that involve comparing interventions. And so the immediate thing you could do is to say, yeah, this doesn't work for my research question because I'm not comparing interventions. See you later. I'd like you to put a little more thought to it than that. Like, just imagine you did want to compare. Some of you, I talked you out of comparing. So imagine you went back to that and you did want to compare. Imagine what you might be able to compare it to. And if you did compare to another independent variable, would you use a alternating treatments design or a multi-treatment design? And my video will explain to you the big difference between alternating treatments designs and multi-treatment designs, and the book goes into some depth on that too. Okay. So, first of all, again, state your research question. Tell us what you learned about designs, these comparison designs, by watching the videos, reading the textbook and the research articles. What was interesting, challenging, goofy, surprising, concerning? And then tell us whether or not a comparison design is right for your research question. And if it's not right, and if you're not, you don't have a research question that's comparing independent variables, can you think of a situation where you might? Can you think of another independent variable you might compare your intervention with? And if you did, would you use an alternating treatments design or a multi-treatment design? Right. Again, this is week 10. We are rolling, guys. And like I said, there won't be a lot left to go. Next week, there'll be one more type of design that we'll learn about. After that week, we'll do the graphing, which is, along with the visual analysis, one of the harder parts of this course. Then we're done with the harder stuff, And all we'll do for the last 3 weeks of class is focus on completing everything. All right? Okay. Everybody, drive on, have a good week. Get hold of me if you need me. Bye.